prices of petrol and diesel hit record levels today after oil marketing companies hiked prices. We're in line with rising global crude oil prices. While OMCs are within their right to hike prices, of course, what the common man is clamoring for is a cut in taxes. The government has hiked excise duty multiple times in the past 4 years on the back of lower crude oil prices globally. But now, when prices are back up, the common man is wondering why taxes haven't been cut. To talk more about the price pinch that the common man is facing and the impact of both state and central finances, we're joined by Kerala Finance Minister Thomas Isaac. Mr. Isaac, thanks so much for speaking to us on Bloomberg Quint. Now, I'd like to start off by asking you, the Union Oil Minister has said that the government will come up with a workable solution. What is that solution? Is it only from the centre, or could we expect a joint effort, a coordinated effort between the states and the central government?
They are just postponing the decision-making movement. What is the solution? This government, after coming to power, has increased tax rates, effective tax rate on diesel by 300 times, 300%, by 200%. Well, that has just rolled back into the status quo. The rate is just existing when they came to power. And we, the states, on our turn, agree that we shall not raise our tax rate to compensate for the fall in our revenue, because we are imposing annual rate. So let the central government just pull back the tax hike they made, and the prices will automatically fall off to, say, something around 60 rupees. And that's the simple solution. Why don't they just pay? What do they want to negotiate, discuss, and so on? The ball is in the court.
No, Mr. Isaac, you know, that's an interesting point, because if we go by the track record of the past 4 years with this government, there's been only one cut in the past 4 years. So the consumers are justified to be so irate. The narrative amongst voters, consumers, and the people in this country seems to be that elections are over, one major election's over, and now the hikes are back. Is that what the government's doing?
Now government has received something like 1 lakh crores rupees of additional revenue by this hike. So the hike mean loss of revenue increase in the fiscal deficit to life. Level. And that's problematic. Secondly, I think the game plan is to continue to mop up the money till sometime around election time, then have a dramatic rollback and make the best out of it. So I think that is the time frame in which they want to do it.
All right, Mr. Isaac. But just to understand this from a state government's point of view, how much of an impact will this have on a state like yours if you were to decide to cut VAT on fuel and give that respite to consumers? That's an argument that has been doing the rounds over the past few months, that the states cut their component of the taxes.
Now, we are receiving something like 6,000 crores, which means about 20% of our tax revenue from this. Now, I never raised any rate. The state government in the last 4 years has not raised the rates at all. So the rate that we have is something historically given to us. Now, I do agree it's a pretty high rate, but that's what the market has got accustomed to. And it's an ad valorem rate. Therefore, if the central government reduces the per liter tax, then automatically our revenue will come down. Now, there's a proposal of including petroleum products in the GST. Well, that's an option that the GST Council can think about. But then I would insist that the law also provides that the states will be compensated if their revenue do not increase by 14%. And there's going to be a severe fall in the revenues of state, and central government would have to compensate. And the compensation wouldn't be sufficient enough. Therefore, before putting petroleum into GST, it's best that GST stabilizes. Then go. Now, for the time being, the best option would be for the center to roll back the tax. At least calibrate the tax downwards so that increase in the crude petroleum price do not result in an increase in the petrol and diesel prices. Because they were raising the excise duty, not just excise duty, additional excise duty, so that the additional money they get is not shared with the states. They were increasing the excise duty so that the decline in the crude oil prices is not transferred to the consumers through lower prices. They were calibrating the excise rate upwards so as to mop up the entire benefit of falling crude oil prices. Now they can do the reverse and the prices will become stable. I do not know why they refuse to do that. Now, Karnataka election has just shown us for 3 weeks the prices did not rise. So don't put the blame on the market and the oil marketing companies. The public sector companies and government can order them to do. We have just seen it being done. I said it can go that way and allow the marketing companies to have a income and suffer losses, right, which government can compensate, or they can calibrate their excess duty downwards so that the increase in the crude oil price does not get reflected in the petrol price.
Mr. Isaac, you know, in one of the scenarios, you mentioned getting petroleum products under GST. Now, that's something that's been gaining traction. That's an argument that's been gaining traction over the past few months. But state governments, strangely, have been resisting it for some of the reasons you mentioned as well. Just to get your take on it, do you think that bringing petroleum products under GST is a feasible solution, so to speak, and would actually, at the end of the day, benefit the customer or the consumer?
Because every state government is cheesed of the way the GST has been implemented in India. It's a mess. Now the government has not lived up to the promises. We don't know when it's going to stabilize. So we are having a knee-jerk reaction to the situation every month when GST Council meets. We have been revising the rates. We have been postponing e-way bill. Now we are revising the return form itself. Now, this being the situation, why do you want to create another unsettle the whole situation through bringing GST, which raises this a major source of revenue for the states? States don't have any other option. They have no other revenue source. Therefore, best option, I would say, before going to GST would be that the central government calibrate its excise duty downwards, just as they did the excise duty upwards, so that the increase in the petroleum crude oil is not forced upon the head of the consumers. That is easily done. There's nothing standing in the way, except I don't know the reason. As I told you, only two reasons: that they don't want the fiscal deficit to rise. Two, they have a game plan already made, a big announcement, perhaps a midnight announcement of bringing down the petroleum prices on the eve of the election.
All right, Mr. Isaac, those are some interesting views, and we really appreciate you joining us on Prime Time.